Welcome to our session.
Canonical.
We will be talking about the CICD hacks. To introduce myself, my name is Lu Tao, responsible for our company's overall business in Asia Pacific. In addition to myself, I will also be having my colleague Zhang Lei Mao doing the presentation together with me. Mao Zhang Lei is our solution architect in our company. My topic today is about how our company quickly construct the CICD and how we will be run native cloud application in the environment of CICD. To introduce our company, Canonical will be firstly use multipass on Ubuntu or Mac OS to construct a virtual machine. And then we use MicroK8s in the virtual machine to create a single node CDK. The CDK is a Canonical distribution Kubernetes. And then we use several tools to very quickly construct the CICD environment. Today's discussion will be following the agenda I just said. I'd like to spend some time introducing CDK because CDK throughout the whole environment is actually very important. My colleague will give us a demonstration how our company very fastly creates CICD environment. Because most of you are technical experts already, Ubuntu is no strange name to you all. Ubuntu is basically everywhere. Before you even realize that, you are using Ubuntu already. We have 60 million. The Docker default language is actually Ubuntu. There is over 60 million Ubuntu image currently being running. There is also 20 million. Ubuntu is also the default language of public cloud. That's over 220 million instances of Ubuntu operating on the public cloud. Is the addition to Docker public cloud on the PaaS platform, including Kubernetes and Apache Mesos and Cloud Foundry. A lot of Ubuntu instances are also being defaulted. There is some quite interesting data, 2 million in 2015, November alone on public cloud, that's 2 million new Ubuntu instances to counting dates, that is 68,000 a day. So every second, there is one new single Ubuntu instances being activated. On the right side, we'll talk about Ubuntu on cloud, on server, in IoT, and in AI and machine learning. Ubuntu has become a default language already. We got autonomous driving cars of Google and Baidu and JD, drones and autonomous driving cars. The default development language is all Ubuntu. Talk about Ubuntu, it is quite a familiar language, but what about the Canonical? When we are facing two clients, the clients may ask me, are we a distributor of Ubuntu in China? Then says no. Canonical is a company behind Ubuntu. Ubuntu is only one of our open source projects. It's just that Ubuntu among the developers is more of a brand name, so you must be familiar with Ubuntu. Ubuntu is led by Canonical. It is an open source project. We provide support. Since it's open source, anyone can contribute to Ubuntu source code. Canonical, we were founded in 2004. Our company is not that big. We have around 600 persons in the world, spreading into three or four different countries. In Asia Pacific, we are in Beijing, Shanghai, Taipei, and Tokyo. Before my colleague gets into the demo of CICD environment construction, I'd like to give a quick talk about CDK. The full name is Canonical Distribution of Kubernetes. Why I'd like to introduce CDK? Throughout Canonical for creating CICD environment, CDK is a very important fundamental platform. As of the CDK, it provides a very stable and the latest upstream Kubernetes. Every half a month, Kubernetes will publish a new upgrade and the security packaging to the CDK. CDK supports the main node clusters. It also supports a parallel scaling up. Canonical also supports CDK's online upgrade and retrieval.
Also, CDK includes Canonical's important product technical feature K8s and Juju. But that requires one day talk, so I don't have time for that. Juju and Charles are technologies which is created by Canonical. The purpose is to make a complicated service application to activate, to make them into a charge parcel and quickly switch module could be deployed and managed. I would give you an example. We know OpenStack, right? Overall speaking, it is a very complicated situation. Traditionally, when you deploy, it takes about two, three days, or even 1 week. It depends how mature the technology you have. But if you use Canonical as a platform to provide a charge model, and so Juju, we deploy it, it will take 2 hours so quickly. OpenStack could be deployed and could be put into production. So that is the advantage of Juju and Charles and the application. Canonical is also deploying its distribution at Charm based on Kubernetes and also deployed by Juju. So that to reduce the deployment of CDK and Kubernetes workload for Canonical. And also CDK from Canonical provides the point to so that can help everyone to test and verify the deploy you have, deployment you have. Therefore,
CDK
is the only one in the market to provide the KBS, but also provide tools and experiences to the developers, and also the software packaging, and also the provision of code for KBS is fairly easy, but it is more difficult to deploy to streamline the management. So CDK, the purpose is to streamline the workload for the client. So later I will give you an explanation of this regard later. And also CDK is the only one in the market that could be based on the public cloud, but also a physical machine. It is a Kubernetes. CDK is perfectly run on Azure, AWS, and Google Cloud, Rackspace. At the meantime, it could operate in private cloud like VMware. If you want the CDK to deploy it in the data center, then the CDK can also be deployed. Also, it can operate on your own PC. The most interesting ones, all of these are using the same tools, also same management strategy. And also CDK has a very complete lifecycle and ecosystem. For instance, it can be integrated with Rancher, so it is a complete PaaS solution.
Also CDK runs on Ubuntu
and Ubuntu itself is Docker cloud language by default.
我稍微简单的总结一下，就是说 CDK 的这个优点放在哪里啊？首先 CDK 呢是 第一个呢，你可以得到一个原生的一个纯的一个 upstream 的 device，
We hope that through Ubuntu and also the tools in your PC, we can use a single virtual machine to set up a CICD environment. So first of all, we'd like to take a look at CICD environment, the pipeline, what kind of components it has. For CI, it is about the integration. Well, for CD, there are two types of understanding. First one, it is for continuous delivery. Delivery means that the codes are packaged or have Docker image, then you push them to your warehouse. Then in the warehouse, the doc register or your personal PPA Ubuntu could be pushed, could be delivered. Then delivery is for the deployment. It is a preparation for deployment. At the stage of deployment, we need to install the software parcel to download your software so that the environment could be the environment for testing or some staged environment. In the end, it will deploy to your production environment. But in this process, we will not talk too much about the CD. We want to go into the details of the tools we use. And also, we will not to deploy, elaborate on the locations you deploy it to. For CICD, it's automatic. For instance, you submit your code, and after internal automation and testing, in the end, it will be deployed to production environment. It usually takes about several minutes or several hours. Generally speaking, it is automated, but for some companies, they need a verification approval function. You need to click it at least to ensure that the process could be continued, and then it can be deployed to a production environment. So here is the CICD pipeline and the tools in the CICD pipeline. Some tools, they are not just for one task. For instance, Jenkins, it is used for CI and also CD. And Jenkins itself also has the pipeline function. Another point I want to make is that it's a Windows tool. It is different from DB of Ubuntu. It's used for IoT application in mobile phones. Well, for Snap, it can be also used for CD deployment. And also, it has good functions. For instance, for Snap, it can support the version semantic checkup when you do software 2.0, 2.1, 2.2. 2 means the first version, the big version, 0. Something, it means the smaller version. And like last one, it means the patch. So when you release the version, for Snappy, it can check and monitor. If you have the updated version of the patch, then it can automatically patch up. And also for Snappy, it supports channel. So in your application, you can use it for stabilizing your beta version or edge version.
So
in the demo environment, these are the tools we use.
So here I'd like to highlight
the environment is actually built on a virtual machine. Our virtual machine is temporary, so it can be deleted at any time, and you can construct it at any time. We provide a mechanism that the tested data can be pushed to the host machine, and cancel it or reconstruct the testing data, or the data you require for application would be lost. And also, we have a CICD environment problem. For instance, it needs to be connected with the internet. By doing that, when you build the CICD environment, the process is very fast. You don't need to download parcels from the internet. And secondly, without internet access, you can still deploy your CICD. And also, the task process is very fast. For unit test, it only takes several seconds, while for package testing, it takes a longer time. Even the whole test, it is also very short time. This is the main tool piece. One is multipass, one is MicroK8s.
Multipass is from Canonical. It is an open source tool. It is used currently to support Ubuntu desktop, Mac desktop, to quickly initiate Ubuntu virtual machine. You don't need to manually install OS. The virtual machine will be automatically set up with also MicroK8s. Multipass also can help you to expand your list to the virtual machine. It can be done vice versa. The list of the virtual machine can also be shared to a host machine. Another important tool is MicroK8s. We mentioned about CDK, Canonical distribution Kubernetes. Single machine version. And also, the parcel could be downloaded. And it is a complete CDK environment. 那这个的话是在我们用的那个CICD的工具，它是在运行在Kubernetes，主要是用了这个jenkins的这个。这个我们是就是演示我们是怎么。So this is a demo how we realize the integrity of the data. During the construction and reassembly of the virtual machine. So here you can see that the MicroK8s we provide add-on function that the registry could be shared to the container of the virtual machine. It can be applied in the container. The whole project is composed of several people, and the code is put in GitHub. We have a lot of open source projects, and CICD MicroK8s is one of them. So this is the demo, and so we are still improving the demo. Currently, the structure is follows. You clone the code, and you run yes or no, then it can be installed. The second step, the virtual machine should be set up. You need to run a script to get rid of multipass to set up the virtual machine. And you log into the virtual machine, and MicroK8s is downloaded by the request alert. Also, number three, you store the storage. So in MicroK8s, you do registry. And sixth step, we provide Jenkins installation scripts, and you install it. And then the images could be downloaded and installed. Last but not least, it's a very small demo about how to run the ultimate target. For the demo is to run KubeCon for AI machine learning.
So before I just talk about the machine, if the client wants
to use a distributed environment, it can also be achieved at a different location or at a different virtual machine. The CNCF environment could be deployed separately, or your testing environment can be separately deployed.
那演示呢，就是说那个，我看一下，我想给大家演示，看一下我们两个关键的工具，一个是multipass，and
MicroK8s。 to demo. This is multipass.
You set up virtual machine,
multipass launch.
Launch.
We're not doing any offline deployment yet. I want to be actually launch it. The virtual machine is created, then you can log in.
Multipass
exec, if you want to execute which VM on what application. And now you can log onto the virtual machines already. We have already installed MicroK8s. The installment is snap install MicroK8s and then classic. It is a classical installment using Ubuntu for the pack. Classical or certification is not limited. If it's not classic on the mobile phone or IoT application, the main significant limitation of the authentication. We also provide add-on features. The MicroK8 is already introduced, and we also provide some add-on features. We got the enabling, and we also provide the dashboard DNS. We have the register storage. And you can take a look at the original status. You can see the dashboard service currently in operation. You can also have it disabled. This will be MicroK8 disabled. As of how to work on it, I'm not so familiar, so I won't be doing any further introduction and demonstration. And we also got the MicroK8 MicroPass. You can also find Kubernetes. And you can also see the README. All of it is on top of here. And if you're interested, you can take a look at it. You can also contact our staff for further communication. That's all I'd like to share today, and thank you.